Almost a month after polls closed on Election Day 2020, President Donald Trump has finally accepted that the peaceful transition of power to President-elect Joe Biden must begin. Previously, the administration had been withholding security briefings and access to office space at the White House from the incoming president. On November 23rd, however, the president finally gave in, but stopped short of outright conceding the election. As such, Trump's seemingly endless election battle might carry on for some time. Still, there are clear indications that Trump will eventually give up the Oval Office to Biden and his vice president, Kamala Harris. Referring to General Services Administration official Emily Murphy, whose office is charged with facilitating the transition of power, Trump tweeted, "In the best interest of our country, I'm recommending that Emily and her team do what needs to be done with regard to initial protocols, and have told my team to do the same." So it may not quite be a concession, but it is something resembling progress, even if it contradicts what Trump's team has been saying on the ground. In the end, however, it might not even matter what Trump and his allies allege about voter fraud. Johannes Abraham, executive director of Biden's transition team, said in a statement, "This final decision is a definitive administrative action to formally begin the transition process with federal agencies. In the days ahead, transition officials will begin meeting with federal officials to discuss the pandemic response, have a full accounting of our national security interests, and gain complete understanding of the Trump administration's effort to hollow out government agencies."
And I must say, the outreach has been sincere. It's not been begrudging so far, and I don't expect it to be.
But that hasn't deterred the Trump campaign. Trump's campaign advisor, Jason Miller, later claimed, without evidence, "We're going to continue to explore all of the fraud and abuse that's been reported to us from the more than 11,000 credible tips we've received from our hotline and website." The Trump team's insistence that there was any degree of voter fraud during the election has yet to be proven, however. In fact, his lawyers have yet to provide any evidence whatsoever. Despite all the bluster, Trump's allies recognize that the peaceful transition must begin sooner rather than later to avoid critical delays once Biden officially takes office. But how long can this back and forth really go on? The thing is, Donald Trump's election fight has to end at some point. According to NBC News, many people close to the president have suggested privately to him that he accept that Joe Biden will become president on January 20th, 2021, and simply continue his legal battles behind the scenes, or at least announce his 2024 candidacy. Still, most states will certify their election results by the first week of December, and the Electoral College will officially vote on December 14th. Biden is slated to win the Electoral College with 306 votes, despite Trump's continued false claims about the election. And it's likely that December 14th will be a watershed moment in the drama of this election. But although the Trump team's claims have not been proven, his stance toward the incoming administration has swayed his supporters, according to a survey conducted by CNBC and Change Research. Although President Donald Trump and his allies are officially beginning the transition to a Biden-Harris administration, his unsubstantiated claims about voter fraud have officially changed the minds of many people who voted for him. The new poll of 1,200 Trump voters showed that only 3% of people polled believe that Biden is the actual president-elect. Another 73% of those polled believe that Trump is the legitimate winner, and 24% aren't sure. Of those that believe Biden didn't win, 31% want Trump to keep fighting in court, and 66% think that the president shouldn't concede. An alarming 81% of the Trump voters polled say that they don't plan on giving Biden a chance as president, even if all the results point to him winning. Just 19% said they would be open to his presidency. Inevitably, what Trump says and does will matter in the coming weeks. Hopefully, everyone just does what's best for the country, whether their favorite candidate is in the White House or not. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Nikki Swift videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.